Now, if you read through the documentation with this, it's like it locks it down, it does whatever. But there are times, especially as a creative, or just for home entertainment, you need to open up firewall ports. Now, obviously, you can do, you know, you can just do, you can go in here, and you obviously, because you've got access to ChatGPT, and this is, it's got, what it's got on here is UFW. So how do I open a port for Plex, which is something you might want to use, on UFW? So thankfully you've got that. Yeah, okay. You need to open TCP port 2030. Now, all of a sudden, you're sort of jumping in, you know, you're jumping into something and you think, how do I do that? Right, so now I've got to open command over here and you'd simply type it. But, you know, it's a really basic service and maybe you just want to do it really easily. So, you know, you just need a GUI. Something I think you'd need a GUI for. It's just such a basic thing, firewalls. You make sure it's on. Thankfully, Omarchy is really secure. It is on. But you want to sometimes edit stuff and you don't want to have to use terminal commands. I mean, they all say with this, it's like, you know, it's very terminal, or, you know, terminal focused for people to, because it's based for developers. So they're all over. But creative people like me, and I'm not saying developers aren't creative, they're very creative people. But basically, people like me, I just want to switch things on, do something, and then jump back into my program and carry on working. So I wrote a script for this. So let me just find it. Okay, so file browser. And basically, what this file browser, what this little script does, downloads, if you drag it over, it's the usual stuff, chmod, whatever, it installs the front end to, which you can do really easily on any Linux distribution. It installs the front end to uncomplicated firewall, which is this. So if I go into this now, I bring it up, apps, and I type in firewall, now it comes up. Now if you try and do this from the Arch package installer, you get like a fires up a box and then you ask to put your password in, but you'll get no further because it's something to do with how it works with Hyperland. So I had a bit of fiddling. I like black screened my machine about four times and had to salvage it to get this to work. So it was worth it. So anyway, now it runs. So just press that. And then it asked me for a passwordy thing. And then there it is in the bottom right corner. So now you've got the GUI to firewall. If I switch it on, and there it is. It's picked up.